Après la présentation du titre, il y a la Père Manuel Mondrao qui est chargé de cette tâche. Après mon introduction, suivra donc la présentation du livre et puis nous demanderons à M. Laurent Roboyer de nous donner un petit résumé en anglais. Suivra des observations commentaires. Et puis après, on écoutera un moment de circonstance de son Excellence Monseigneur l'évêque. Et après son mot du jour, on procédera à une distribution du livre pour quelques individus. Et puis ceux qui ont un peu de sous voudront bien également acheter, se procurer son bouquin. C'est pas cher. Et il y a un prix de promotion pour le jour. Si je ne me trompe pas, c'est une somme. Et puis, on aura une prière de conclusion et une photo de groupe. Le moment venu, on vous présentera ceux qui recevront ce livre en cadeau du jour. Excellence Monseigneur, Monsieur l'Abbé Cassien Moïda Haï, Monsieur l'Abbé Emmanuel Mugabo, distingués invités, chers confrères, frères et sœurs, agents de l'INES, chers étudiants, ce livre pour une éthique de la justice et de la paix retrouve aux sources magistère social de l'Église de Léon XIII à Pie XII, édition Parotti Presse, publié le 17 juin 2023, a été préfacé par notre évêque, Son Excellence Monseigneur Vincent Abimana, évêque du diocèse de Mégui. Son Excellence affirme dans la préface pour découvrir de la pertinence du discours social de l'Église dans ses aspects de la justice et de la paix, se révèle comme un remède fondamental face au marasme d'une société à l'église de valeur. Son présent livre est une contribution à cette démarche, un outil pour la pastorale sociale de l'Église en faveur des intellectuels et pour tous ceux qui souhaitent que la justice et la paix se répandent dans le monde. Fin de citation, page 4. L'auteur écrit à la page 21. En date du 12 septembre 2019, le pape François lance une invitation en faveur de l'initiative du pacte éducatif global qui sera, d'une façon générale, axé sur cet engagement, mettre la personne au centre, écouter les jeunes générations, promouvoir la femme, responsabiliser la famille, ouvrir l'accueil, renouveler l'économie et la politique et prendre soin de la maison commune. C'est un appel à dialogue sur la façon de construire l'avenir et de cette maison commune pour un changement exigeant, un parcours éducatif afin de faire mûrir une nouvelle solidarité universelle et une société plus accueillante. Fin de citation. Plus tard, il affirmera, il n'y a pas de paix sans justice. Son volume est le deuxième, comme je disais au début. C'est le deuxième livre de l'abbé Cassien présenté dans cette même salle. Le premier étant pour une éthique de la fraternité et de la solidarité autour aux sources, plus d'un siècle du discours social de l'Église, présenté ici le 27 août 2021. L'abbé Cassien Brigavi est un prêtre du diocèse de Ruyenieri et l'un des promoteurs de l'INES Ruyenieri. Il a été ordonné prêtre en 1999. Il a étudié au petit séminaire Saint-Dominique Savion de Ruissero et au grand séminaire Autongo, Kavua et Inyakiwanda et Saint-Dominique à Lusaka, Zambie. L'abbé Cassien a été préfet des études et recteur au petit séminaire Saint-Jean de Rouma et a fait une spécialisation en théologie morale à Catholique Université d'Eurven, Bruxelles, Belgique. Et où il est sorti avec un doctorat en théologie morale et un diplôme en Academic Teacher Education. Il est actuellement chancelier du diocèse de Ruyenieri et vicaire judiciaire.
Excellence, Monseigneur, Vincent Rodman, AFP du diocèse de Ruyenieri. Monseigneur l'abbé Zimengo, vicaire général de Ruyenieri. Monsieur l'abbé docteur Cassien Rinaldi, Monsieur l'abbé docteur Jean-Bosco Valéja, recteur de l'INES Réunéry, Monsieur les abbés religieux et religieuses, représentants de la communauté universitaire de l'INES Réunéry, distingués délégués, Mesdames, Messieurs, frères et sœurs. C'est un grand honneur pour moi de me tenir devant vous pour vous présenter le livre très important que l'abbé Cassien Rinaldi vient de publier aux éditions Aloki Press. Cet ouvrage s'intitule Une éthique de la justice et de la paix. Retour aux sources, magistère de l'Église, magistère social de l'Église, de Léon XIII à Pie XII. Cette prise d'initiative d'écrire un livre qui est un thème important auquel un grand public semble se soucier très peu aujourd'hui est une tâche qui nécessite du courage et une détermination exceptionnelle. En effet, la tendance actuelle qui s'impose à grande vitesse grâce à l'usage massif des outils technologiques et celle de se contenter de fragments de connaissances et d'informations passagères généralement destinées au simple divertissement et même à la distraction. Le travail que notre auteur vient d'accomplir en faveur d'un public réellement soucieux de valeurs fondamentales de la vie sociale mérite de notre part un hommage spécial et de vives félicitations. C'est pour cela que je vous invite tous de manifester à notre auteur notre reconnaissance par un grand applaudissement.
À la conseillère. Buri wese muri twe hari ibyo yahisemo kuzirikana njyewe nari gitekereza ijambo yavuze cyangwa se interuro la technologie qui libère de la fatigue et de la pensée. La technologie vient nous libérer. La réalité ne se sépare jamais de la vérité. C'est conscience, sa conscience, ce n'est que ruine de l'âme. C'est une phrase que nous connaissons déjà, mais qu'il faut toujours répéter. Somme au vase et sims de notre understand enough French. And for that reason, we have chosen to have a very short summary in English, and I would like to invite Flora to come here and help us and help those who would like to gain insights from this presentation.
Let me talk about the preface. You know, the preface is like an introduction of the book. The preface of this book was done by His Lordship Bishop of a Diocese, Vincent Imam. He writes, I quote, "The position of the Catholic Church about social issues is confined in the pontiff documents, and it's not easy to understand them. It's not easy to understand exactly what they mean. This book is therefore going to give its contribution in understanding the leadership of different popes, from His Holiness Pope Leon the 13th to His Holiness Pope Pius the 12th. And their leadership is transparent in their official documents. Their pontiff ministry took place in the tumultuous and agitated period characterized by industrial revolution with many conflicts and damages. Peace and justice in that period were very threatened. It's therefore important to understand the position of the Catholic Church in the matters of peace and justice. This is henceforth a handbook for intellectuals and pastoral ministers." End of quote. The structure of the book. The book has two parts. Part one has four chapters, while part two has six texts that the author analyzed in these four chapters. These texts are the following. The first text is the encyclical letter written by His Holiness Pope Leo XIII in 1891, and it was written on workers' living conditions. The second text is the epistle written by the Sacred Congregation of the Vatican Council to the Bishop Bernard of Lille in France in 1929 on conflict between the Association of Northern Masters and the Syndicate of Christian Workers. The third document is an encyclical letter written by His Holiness Pius XI in 1931, which was written on the restoration of social order. The fourth document is an encyclical letter written by His Holiness Pope Pius XI in 1937 to the Holy German Empire on the critical condition of the Roman Catholic in that German Empire. The fifth document is an encyclical letter written by His Holiness Pope Pius XI on the atheist communism. The last text, it means text number six, is a radio message by His Holiness Pope Pius XII, which was written on social matters. It was on the occasion of the 50th anniversary of the encyclical letter written by Leo XIII. So what was the source of information? You can ask yourself, where did the author get this information? Because as academicians, that's the question we ask ourselves. So the first source of information, as the author mentions it, is from the internet. The second source of information was the Centre de Recherche d'Action Sociale des Jésuites Français. In English, Center for Research and Social Action of French Jesuits in France. Then, problem statement. What was the problem that was haunting the author to write this book of 400 pages? The question that was haunting the author is the following. Can there be peace and justice in a world full of wars and conflicts? In his attempt to answer this question, the author wanted to go back to the source, to go to the beginning, to see how the situation was before, and how the situation is now, how the situation can be analyzed. So he went back to the time, to the 90s, to the 80s and 90s, to see how the situation was. So the answer for this question is summarized in four chapters. Chapter 1. In chapter 1, the author explores some elements and aspects justifying the return to sources. They include, among others, the educational pact and synodality, society in turmoil, tradition, justice and peace, as the virtues that are threatened, why fraternity and solidarity are values to be revitalized. The second chapter gives the nomenclature or types of pontif documents that he is using. You know, there are many types of pontif documents that many people are not familiar with. So they include encyclical letters, apostolic constitution, exhortation, apostolic letters, pontiff decrees, pontifical bull, papal brief, indulge, descript, homily, message, pope addresses, etc. So there are many, there is a special terminology that is used in the pontiff communication.
In chapter 3, the author is discussing the life of this Pope from 1878 to 1958. He is going through their life, what they did, and the different messages they gave. The last chapter, which is the most important, is the chapter in which those documents were analyzed. The first document that the author analyzed is an encyclical letter written by His Holiness Pope Leon XIII, written on 15 May 1891, written in the period of Industrial Revolution in Europe, in which a lot of human power was demanded. However, workers were exploited and living in misery. In this context, the encyclical letter attacked these abuses of workers' dignity. The second document that was analyzed is the epistle written by the Sacred Congregation of the Vatican Council to the Bishop Lienard of Lille in France on 5th June 1929 on conflicts between the Association of Northern Patrons or Masters and the syndicates of Christian workers. It was like a court judgment document between two opposing sides. Actually, an association of masters has filed the case to the High See in Rome in January 1921, complaining about the behavior of Christian syndicates in Lille, France. And these syndicates were accused of being in complicity with the Marxist syndicates. After some period of investigation, the verdict was in favor of the Christian syndicates. So that was the second document that the author analyzed. The third document that the author analyzed was the encyclical letter written by His Holiness Pope Pius XI, written on 15 May 1931, on restoration of social order. It was written in the context of economic crisis in Europe and America caused by World War II. It was a period of unemployment. We are witnessing that accentuated intervention of the state at the social level, rise of fascism in Italy, and the nationalism and the socialism in Germany. The fourth document is the encyclical letter written by His Holiness Pope Pius XI on 14th March 1937 to the Holy German Empire on the critical condition of the Roman Catholic Church in German Empire. This letter depicts the sufferings and the lack of peace in Germany in the period that preceded the World War II. Its aim was to preach the word of truth and a spiritual comfort in the period of tribulations characterized by a tested faith, religious freedom confiscated. The fifth document analyzed was the circular letter written by His Holiness Pope Pius XI on 19th March 1937 on the atheist communism. This letter rejects communism ideology, which is considered as erroneous doctrine, which denies the existence of God and life after death. This communism is in favor of evolutionism that was promoted by Karl Marx. This ideology deprives human beings of their rights and dignity. In addition, this ideology rejects any authority established by God. Christians, therefore, should not be indulging into materialism but practice charity works. The last document that the author analyzed is the radio message by His Holiness Pope Pius XII on the World War which was written to the whole world. It's a message of love, encouragement, and comfort. It was written, no, it was given, it's an address that was given on the 50th anniversary of the encyclical letter by His Holiness Leo XIII, entitled Rerum Novarum, which was written in the period of World War II. In that period of war, it was difficult for the Pope to visit Christians. So he used that radio, which was a new innovation, which was a new invention, to give the message to Christians that were scattered across the globe. So a radio, a new invention, was used as an instrument of evangelization. Therefore, the church is not supposed to be silent in case there is danger. In the conclusion, the author uses the message of Pope Paul VI, which was addressed on the occasion of instituting the World Day of Peace in 1967, to state his conclusion. He says, I quote, "Peace is not based on rhetoric, but on respect of foundations of sincerity, justice, and love. Peace does not mean pacifism. It's therefore necessary to educate the world to love peace and love. Peace and justice go together like peas and carrots. In this way, if you love peace, you have to work for justice. Peace is therefore possible if people want it. Peace is possible if we dream about it together. We need to accept fraternity and solidarity and reject individualism and indifference." Thank you.
Thank you very much. Laurent Nizeyimana is the head of department of French English education here at INES. Thank you very much for the work of summarizing the whole document I've done just in half one. So,
Je vais vous faire un peu de temps.